What's up, YouTube? It's Boom. BIGUNCS coming at you with a 10 question horror tag video. Excuse me. Before we begin, it must be said, and I believe it was my last video, or second to last video.
Let's say 99% sure I will not be back in Oceanside.
I said I would probably never be shooting another video. No, actually, I think I said I will never be shooting another video from Oceanside, California. But here I am. I had to come back because doing a little house sitting. Little dog sitting. So I'll be here for about a week.
A week? That's 7 days.
My dad's house, and then I went to LA to help one of my buddies with a script because he's got a meeting on Thursday, and hopefully he can sell it. A little moolah coming my way. This is the international sign for moolah, in case you didn't know. All right, so let's get on to the video. I saw this horror tag, it was done by Miss Lisa Loves, and she got it from Last Venom 76's. So here we go. Question one. What is your favorite horror movie opening sequence? So that was most of the opening to 28 Weeks Later. I think that whole, the scene, that's probably one of my, that is my favorite opening sequence to a horror movie. The movie itself, so-so. There's a few other parts in there that are pretty good, but overall, 28 Days Later is way better than 28 Weeks Later. But I think, the key moment in there is when he's trying to get his wife to go with him. And she decides to go after this random kid that is the one that kind of screwed up everything for him because they were living in the quiet place. So, anyways, 28 Weeks Later, opening sequence. Question two. What are your three favorite horror movie quotes? First one.
When there's no more room in hell, the dead will walk the earth.
When there is no more room in hell, the dead will walk the earth.
I think the third one was good. Also,
you're gonna need a bigger boat.
I actually say that, and then
David.
This is not pretend of it.
I will not be threatened by a walking meatloaf.
Not a big fan of the movie, but I definitely like that quote. Question 3. King or Kubrick, whose vision of The Shining do you prefer? I saw the King version one time, way back when it came out on TV. I can't honestly say I cared for it that much. I actually, at this point right now, don't really remember anything. And I've seen the Kubrick version minimum half dozen, maybe 10 times. So I'm going to have to go on Kubrick.
Question 4.
What is your favorite creature feature? I'm going to have to go with A Cabin in the Woods. I really enjoyed that movie. I know not a lot of people enjoy that movie, but I really like that movie. And they seem to have pretty much all the creatures in the movie. And I kind of hope they do a part 2 or maybe a prequel, because I really want to kind of find out about that whole the organization or whatever. I think getting more information on that would be really interesting. And also because I'm kind of hoping that we get to find out who Kevin is. Who's Kevin? Who's Kevin? What's he doing there? All right. So, Cabin in the Woods.
Question 5.
What movie do you dislike that everyone else seems to like? There are two movies that come to mind, and these aren't movies that I'm like everybody's like raving about, but I can honestly say I've never heard anybody say anything negative about these movies, and that is The Descent and High Tension. Now, I'm not going to throw out any spoilers or nothing in case anybody hasn't seen it yet, but excuse me. High Tension is one of the dumbest movies I've ever seen in my life. I was watching the movie and I was kind of into it a little. You know, I was like, hey, it's not bad. I kind of liked the character. I was like, yeah. And then flip, ruined movie, makes it the dumbest movie. Completely it should not have been made. And The Descent, I have to admit, I'm not a huge fan of movies where, The Hills Have Eyes 2, where, you know, you have this, that hundreds or thousands of people have gone through and they all got killed by these people or these things or whatever. But somehow this little ragtag group of morons that we're watching, they survived. I mean, I think The Hills Have Eyes 2 had a couple of redeeming qualities to it, whereas The Descent has no redeeming qualities to it.
Question 6.
In any type of horror movie scenario, who would you like to team up with for your survival? Now, I'm going to assume that they want to know if there's any other movie characters that we want to be teamed up with, instead of me saying, you know, my buddy Rick and that guy James that lives down the street with all the guns. So I thought about this, and I decided that the best person to be teamed up with, Predator.
Yeah, not that one.
The big one. The grown-up one. That's the one right there. That guy. Yeah. AVP 3. starring Big Unks. I think we could pretty much survive most horror movie scenarios.
Question 7.
If given creative control over your favorite movie, what would you change? Well, I think like most people, my favorite movie changes from time to time, from hour to hour, minute to minute, depending on what I've recently watched and whatnot. So at this moment, I am going with The Devil's Rejects as my favorite movie. And if I was given final edit on this film, I would have A, made it probably about 20 minutes longer. B, I would have included the deleted Back to Satan scenes, because I kind of into the Dr. Satan character from House of a Thousand Corpses. So when I found out that they had shot some scenes in this movie, I probably would have, I mean, I don't know what they shot, so if they were good, but I would have liked to have included some Dr. Satan stuff. And I really liked the movie review guy. I mean, was it Mort, I think his name was. And so I would have made his scene longer, because that guy, he's got some secrets. And finally, you know, being a horror movie, you got to have a little bit of the old TNA, so I would have included some, a little bit of, yeah. What are two favorite artwork covers to horrible movies? So I now understand that to mean what really bad movies, what two really bad movies have kind of cool posters. So for that, I came up with The Boy, the most recent adaptation of The Boy. I'm sure everybody's seen it, but this poster sold me on the movie, because that just looks creepy. It looks like a little kid sitting in a hallway facing away from the camera, like he's looking at something, you don't know what he's looking at, you don't know what's going on. And then this, which is a older movie, I want to say late 70s, I think. Oh no, I think it might even be the early 80s. And I don't know, there's something about this poster I've always enjoyed. I always thought that was a kind of cool poster. So, those were my two. Question 9! What is a movie you've tried to watch several times, but for some reason you can't get through it? This is probably going to bring me a lot of hate mail or whatever. But I have attempted to watch The Evil Dead maybe a half dozen times, the original, and I can't get through it. I don't know what it is, but I'm always asleep by usually like halfway. I know I watched it, you know, way, way back, and I have seen it in entirety, but I had to, like I said, I watched about 6 times and was out by about midway. And then once I started at the midway point and watched it through to the end. So I haven't watched it all the way through at one point without falling asleep. So I don't know. But
question number 10.
What movie would you like to have in your collection that you do not already own? There's actually a movie collection that I would like to have in my collection, and that is the Ilsa/Wanda movies. There's 4 of them. There's Ilsa, the She-Wolf of the SS, which I don't know if you know, it was filmed on the Hogan's Hero set. Ilsa, the Something to the Oil Sheiks, and then there's Ilsa, Tigress of the Siberia. And then there's Wanda, the Warden. I've seen all of those movies. It's been a while. I actually owned the Tigress and the SS, but I lost them. So I would like to get all four of those movies from my collection. I don't know. I'm gonna have to check. I don't know if they have like a box set, you know, maybe like a bust of Diana Thorne, hopefully in that Tigress of the Siberia outfit with the fur coat and the hat, and that'd be kind of cool. So that is the 10 questions. I hope you enjoyed my video. So I'm gonna tag Big Ol' Geek, Oblivion, NerdXCore, and Marie Gifford. You tagged!